human factors has become a hot topic recently, and in this video we're going to take a look at the series of events and key publications that have led to an increasing interest in human factors in healthcare. As I briefly alluded to, interest in human factors has been building momentum, and in healthcare this momentum has been building since about the 1980s and 1990s, when some key publications were published, and that's gathered evidence and also gathered momentum for examining medical errors and their root causes. The first paper that we have is McIntyre and Popper, A Critical Attitude in Medicine. This was published in the USA and actually looked at some of the critical attitudes of doctors and healthcare professionals and why errors were being occurred. Moving through the 80s, we had in 1984 an analysis of major errors of equipment and failures in anaesthesia. Not looking at the social and personal aspects, this actually looked at the equipment errors that were leading to deaths during anaesthesia. But these were also some human factors in terms of equipment being checked and checklists available. And what this paper found was that actually a lot of deaths during anaesthesia were attributed to equipment not being understood or not being checked for errors. Next we have one called Brennan et al. From 1991. And this is Adverse Events and Negligence in Hospitalized Patients. And this was a paper from America that then sparked a paper from Leap in 1994, Errors in Medicine, which was based in the UK. And both these papers found key failings in teamworking, communication, hospital systems that then led to errors in healthcare and started to lead up to the interest in human factors. These two reports, one from the USA and one from the UK, raised some common key points. And the first was that research into fails in health was sparse. And as we can see previously in the 80s and 90s, there was only about 4 or 5 research articles that actually looked at failures in human factors and preventable error relating to health. What they also unearthed was that blame cultures were present, and typically when they were investigating errors, blame was placed on individuals rather than looking at the errors as a whole. And as we've previously seen, there's normally multiple errors that then cause the user and the operator to make an error. These are the active errors that we create, and the multiple errors are the latent errors. And this is because the causes of the failures stretch beyond the individual and are typically ingrained in the system as well, which is why we need human factors to help us design these systems and try and help humans interact with the systems more efficiently. And ultimately, opportunity to learn from these incidents was limited, and what we were doing is reporting the incidents, but not actually learning at them. While now in the NHS, there's a key drive to actually learn from mistakes with root cause analysis, but we can concede that there are still blame cultures present. And typically when an error does happen, in my experience, we then blame the individual rather than the things that led them to make that error and try and correct those to prevent an error in the future.